This video continues on a series of videos when I've been looking at the connections within a ceiling rose and pendant and within a light switch. And I've been asked the question, what about the old colours, Gary? So if I take it off and we can look in here, we've got the old arrangement. And this links in nicely to what I used to ask my learners to do in that first 4 or 5 weeks at college when we were working on lighting circuits, was to take a photograph of the inside of one of their ceiling rose and pendants and bring it into college. And 50% of the learners would have this colour arrangement. And of course, we wouldn't be working with these cable colours. They were phased out in 2004. So quite a long time ago, especially if you're a 16-year-old learner starting off a full-time college course. Now, apprentices will be more familiar with these because they're working every day in wiring systems that have mixtures of old and new cable colours. And I'm sure with 2004, that is very old to some people. But this is the arrangement we've got in a ceiling rose and pendant that may well be in a dwelling or at home itself. So let's go through what we've got here. And if you watch the other videos in the series, this will make a lot of sense. If it's first new to you, I do recommend checking out some of those other videos. So exactly the same arrangement in our ceiling rose and pendant. We've got our blocks at the top. We've got a block of two, which is our switching line conductor. We've got a block of three, which is usually identified as loop. And then another block of three, which is our neutral connections, but we're in the old cable colours. So let's start with neutral. In our new system, we know from our previous videos that the neutral was a blue conductor, and it will also be a blue conductor coming down in your flex that goes down to your pendant. So that would be blue in old and new systems, but we can see here that our neutral colour is black. So pre-2004, the neutral colour was black. So we've identified that one there as our neutral connection in our block of three. Remember, we like to leave the outside one for this flex that goes down to the pendant. Okay, so that's why that one's left blank. But that's a solid block of three for our neutral connections, and they're black. Our loop connection, which is our permanent line in, permanent line out, and permanent line down to the switch. I know often on site people are calling that the live conductor, but it's actually the line conductor. And again, we've got a solid block of three. And this time, rather than being, as we've seen in our other videos, that connection being brown, pre-2004, the line connection was identified as red. So line in, line out, and line down to the switch. That block of three there. And then on our end one, this is our switching line conductor. Again, we could have used either of the terminals, it wouldn't have mattered, but again, we like to leave the outside one free. We've got a black conductor, which isn't a neutral, which is identified with some red oversleeving, which is our switching line conductor. And we know that, again, the outside one generally is left for the flex that goes down to our pendant. So that would be on the outside one there. So if we've got a switching line this side and a neutral this side, when we operate our switch, we can turn on the lamp that's connected to the pendant. So that's that. And as always, we've got a connection for our circuit protective conductors in here. And we've got three of those, and they're identified with green and yellow sleeving. If you're looking at a really, really, really old one, you might find it's a solid green. But we're looking at green and yellow for our circuit protective conductors in here. Even 2004 had green and yellow as our CPC, our circuit protective conductor, and they're held in there. So that's our arrangement with the old cable colours. Let's just recap. So we've got black is our neutral. Red, in this case, is our permanent line connection. And a black identified with red sleeving is our switching line conductor. And if I just bring this one in, what's really good, it used to be an exam question. Right at the top there, it actually says the rated value of voltage, and it's 250 volts. We know the nominal value of voltage for a single phase circuit is 230 volts. But the rated value of this ceiling rose and pendant is 250 volts. And that links in almost nicely with the voltage range. It can go up 10 and down 6 from that 230 volt range. So plus 10 is 253 volts, which is very close to the maximum voltage rating of here of 250. So that used to be an old exam question. It may still come back up. So there are connections within our ceiling rose and pendant. Let's just move it down and look at the switch. So we'll be taking our permanent line, our switching line, and CPC connection down to our one gang. So one gang meaning we've got one switch on the front, one gang. And when I turn it over, we've got a one-way switch. Our permanent line connection now in red comes in, and we've put it into common. It wouldn't matter in a one-way switch whether it was in common or normally identified the other one as L1, but we like to put it into common. That's our permanent line connection. And our black one, again, which now isn't a neutral, is a switching line conductor and is identified by red sleeving. And this time it's gone into a connection, which is L1. Sometimes it's identified as one way. So that makes our switch. So when we operate our switch, we put the permanent line through the switch onto our black, identified with red sleeving, our switching line conductor, we turn on the light. And obviously when we operate the switch, we take that line connection off from here and the light goes off. We have got a fully insulated system here, but our circuit protective conductor is held within the earth terminal within the back of the box. Just in case it's changed, either the switch or back box, it's usually the switch, isn't it? The back boxes, if they're sunk in the wall, are metal. Oh,
CPC secure to the back box. If you happen to put it on and down
these surface accessories. And at college, I used to make some of my learners change the light switch from a plastic one to a metal one, meaning that even if they were going onto a plastic box, because that's generally what we had at college, the CPC needed disconnecting and connecting to the metal light switch because that was an exposed conductive part. Let's just have a little look at the sealing rosin pendant and just discuss some other points. We've got a cord grip, so this goes around here to support the flexible cable that goes down to our pendant to stop the full strain being on the terminals. So we wouldn't want the pressure of the light fitting, maybe you've got a shade on there as well as the lamp, being stressing against the terminal. So we bring it round there in a loop and that becomes a strain relief for it. So it stops you pulling against those connections. And if I undo this one here, which is a manufactured one, you'll see something else. You'll just see a little ferrule in there. So if I just bring it around and undo that, you'll see the end of these from the manufacturer was actually got a ferruled connection. Just pop that out. That little gold, it can be silver in color. That little tube over the top of those fine stranded conductors, this is a class 5 cable to stop those spraying out and being damaged by screwing into them. They're actually got a ferrule on the end as well. So that's something else to bear in mind. So that was our effectively our switching line connection. And we look at the end of this one and we can see our two pins in there for our connections as well as our supporting areas on these as well. So this here is a slightly different arrangement because you'll notice there's three connections on here. This was designed for a special type of lamp, but it still had the two connecting pins. So if I bring in this next one, you can just see here again, we've only got now two connection pins. So this will take a standard Bayonet cap lamp where this one used to take a specially designed one that you could only fit in a certain type of lamp. Well, let's look at a more traditional one. So our two connecting points are either side and our electrical connecting points are these two pins here. And if we bring it in, we've got the following. We've got the end of our Bayonet cap lamp. So two connecting pins for electricity are these two. And these two here connect and hold into position the lamp. So if I pop that into there and I then give it a little twist, those two outside pins, okay, lock it into position so it stops it falling out. So push it in and twist it, and that's held into position. And we've made our electrical connection on these two connecting pins here, or connecting points, are here and here. And you've heard me say many times on the channel, this Bayonet cap lamp holder has no polarity. So it doesn't matter which one of these is line, in this case, switching line and neutral. So it doesn't matter which one of these is switching line and neutral in this style of Bayonet cap lamp. And we know that this tungsten filament one has now been superseded by LEDs. However, on the channel, you will see me discussing all kinds of lamps that are still requirements for the end exam. So the interesting bit here is this is a Bayonet cap lamp. A Bayonet cap lamp has no polarity. So in other words, it doesn't matter which one of these is switching line and which one of them is neutral. Our two connecting pins to hold it into position of the outside ones, the electrical connections of the two pins in there. And if we just bring the other one in, that's a slightly different style. And we can see our two connecting pins there for a Bayonet cap lamp. So there we have it. That's looking at the older cable colours pre-2004, and you'll be expected to understand and be able to identify them. The black one being our neutral, the red one being our line conductor. And if we were using a black as a switching line, we identify it now with red sleeving, where previously we discussed identifying conductors with brown sleeving, but obviously we can't this time. This system is using red as a line colour, so our switching line conductor is identified by red sleeving. So that summarizes pre-2004 cable colors. We now know at college we're working with the modern cable colors, brown line, blue neutral, and as always, our green and yellow conductor is our circuit protective conductor. But as always, I hope this video has been some help.